wandering heights. It is well named for Heathcliff's dwelling. On this bleak hilltop, the earth is hard with a black frost, and a north wind blows over his head. No wonder the grass grows up between the flags, and cattle are the only hedge cutters.
Hush, sir! The master must know you're here. He lets no one lodge in this house willingly.
Your master's a queer man.
Aye, sir, rough as a sword and hard as a windstorm.
He must have had some ups and downs in his life to make him such a churl, to live in this lonely place and begrudge his own tenant a knight's hospitality, to snarl like an angry cur, hardly sign of friendliness, to set his dogs upon me as in Peter's town. I would have pulled me in from him, but for you.
Aye, sir, it is a cruel house, and I think it is not long for me. Best go to bed now, sir. The wind howls, and it is very cold, and make no sounds. Good night.
Good night. No, not for 20 years. No, take your hand away. John, no, no, no!
I've got in at a window at Miss Catherine Henshaw. It told me she had been walking the earth this winter.
No, no!
I was lying there, I heard the gusty wind and the driving of the snow. I heard the purple reap its teasing sound, and I must have dreamt, but it seems to me I rose and right on hasp the casement. I heard the servant to the stable, knocking my knocker through the glass, and stretching an arm out to seize the branch. My fingers close on an ice cold hand.
Yes!
Go on! I try to draw back my arm, but the hand clung to it, and the voice sobbed. Are you? I asked. Face looking through the window.
No! No!
Terror made me cruel. I pulled his wrist out of a broken head and ran it to and fro. And the blood ran down and the fingers relaxed. Egon! I shouted.
Come in, oh, come.